she is coming.
She is. She had a Boston and she was going to come out with me like in here, but she was 7:30, so.
Are we using the camera on?
I don't care. You can if you want to, or you can shut it off. It doesn't matter to me. She's taping it, so I don't know if you have to take it.
Now we're doing double tapes these days.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll call the meeting to order at
8:15.
Yes, because it's technically your meeting.
Okay.
So, okay, so we're here because of the declining amount of enrollment that we have that's causing us to have a deficit. So, does anybody have any updated numbers?
What do you want them for?
I believe there is a teen registration in the box, by the way.
Oh, let's get that.
I can't get that because I don't have the key.
I don't have my keys in the car.
Oh.
Well, the little box on the ballot box, because it could go in the ballot box, so I can't open that. So you're going to have to come in tomorrow if you could.
Okay.
I was planning on coming in tomorrow.
But there is one in there.
Okay. And you don't, it is a teen registration?
They said teen. That's what I heard.
Where are we in teen numbers?
So, I just did, for each week, so we have 10 kids for the first week, there are 5 for the second week, 8 for the third, 3 for 4, 8 for 5, 3 for 6, and 4 for 7. So,
so we're not even anywhere near the projected budget.
Well, we're for 3, more than half. 10 is pretty good.
I thought you did 15 though.
Well, but 15 included a director and an assistant director. Mm-hmm. So at this point in time, we don't need a counselor. So that officially chops off 2650 off the top
mm-hmm.
of the budget line. What on our salary we actually hired our person at a lower rate than what is on our budget line, so there's an extra $263 on that one. So doing just that quick math, that brings us down to $11,697. As we spoke the last time, you know, our biggest problem is transportation, and that's our biggest cost, and we're really trying to think, you know, outside the box and mm-hmm. what we could do. And so I sat with my insurance guy today, and he said if there are people willing, if we could have volunteer drivers who will take their vehicle, which one of them would be mine if I was driving. So, the first week of camp, I don't know if we talked to you about the first week of camp, but the director that we hired, I think you know this, is still in school. Mm-hmm. She's at York, so they have class Monday, Wednesday. So I was actually going to go on that field trip on Wednesday as the person in charge. So, like that, we don't need a bus for. I'm driving my van as long as I have that certificate of insurance. Which is like, what is it, Nancy? 311-133 and 300,000.
It's 100,000, 300,000 liability.
Right. And that allows you to drive kids on school field trips. Like that's what I did when my kids went to preschool.
So then you need to have a permission slip as well from the parent who's going to authorize you to be the driver and not a bus.
Right.
I would assume so too. Do you know what the policy is for town on that? Because I know that I asked and they said no on rentals.
Well, here's my...
I believe if it's the owner driving their vehicle,
right.
That was the stipulation.
That's
and
what
I can verify
too.
That.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure that it...
Yeah, that's what I thought too. Like, you had mentioned that you would let someone drive your van.
Right.
You know, and but then
I tried to pull that one too.
Yep, and they said no, no. And they said no on a rental of a van.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Huh.
So, because the person's going to be driving the rental
right.
van,
right.
So they said no to that as well.
Right.
So I'd asked that at last meeting. So, and did you find out anything about what was that, the one you were in Rochester that you were going to check on?
Oh, that was nice.
way too expensive.
Yeah, it seems like nothing is.
It was like over $400.
I called UNH Transport, and they don't do charters anymore, mm-hmm. and.
I checked in with the SAU office about their minivan, and they said it's for special needs kids, and it was purchased with special needs funds. We can go ahead and contact the special ed director for the district, but the people within their office highly doubted they would give it away for use because it needs to be on school property in case they need it for one of their special needs kids.
I had a feeling that was going to be the answer to that as well.
So I do have a business card for them too, and that, if we have 10 campers, it wouldn't fit all 10 campers because it's a seven passenger vehicle.
Okay, all right.
So,
do you want to give her, let her look at some of those numbers that we compiled for the teen camp?
So, do you want my corrections on that?
So, we have 6, 9, 7.
So right now our income, so we may have more than that because Dee has not entered everything into the system yet. So we keep getting paper.
So I only see what's on SI. She has all the paper copies.
I think right now there's only one that is one paper that she told me about. Well, I have this here in front of me too. I have two, at least two registrations, but I've counted them into this. So it's really if anybody's coming in this week, which we've had a few inquiries on the webpage about it. Can I still sign up my kid? There's a number of people that are still asking us
and
those questions.
A flyer went out today to all the RGS kids that said one more week on it. Went home with the back text, and I need to drop flyers off to the summer tour schools. We have permission to drop off at Maplewood and Idlehurst, and I talked to them today. And they can either do it by email, but that doesn't reach a portion of their students, or I can stop by tomorrow with paper copies and it'll go home in every backpack.
But Maplewood and Idlehurst is not teen.
Right.
So that doesn't have teen camp.
And teen already went home to everybody in
middle school. Okay. So the thing is that it has to be self-supporting or we can't have it. That's the bottom line. So that was the decision of the board last week, and if it isn't, there's no revenue in the budget to cover it, especially when we're talking, I mean, I got D's from Raleigh, and we're 10,000 in debt there, because Raleigh's numbers.
We don't have all the income yet.
Yeah, we don't have all the income yet. I'm just telling you what D gave me.
You have payment plans coming in. You won't have your last payment plan until July 23rd.
Do you know what the balance is of people who have signed up that still
don't
money?
You're a webmaster.
And I can't log in. I told you that. All my email addresses aren't. They're not even letting me reset a password. I can't go in.
You didn't tell me that. I'm sorry.
So I have no idea what's going on in there. But do you know
so
how
you
much?
So you haven't been able to pull any of that information?
No, and I arranged that with Dee, so that's not an issue right now as far as reconciling the bank account goes. But it would still be helpful to know how much money is outstanding for who you have registered already.
Right, and I believe, and I had that conversation with Dee, and I think, I don't believe we can run that number until it closes on the 15th.
Dee sent me today's, and hers is the latest and greatest report, so I'm not sure what you're saying, but Dee's Raleigh numbers, she's telling me, is the latest and greatest numbers, and right now, it's 10,000 in the hole.
But you don't have, if you signed up online, you were allowed payment plans this year.
But she's counting the person. So the payment plan, it's not necessarily revenue in-house, it's projected revenue.
Are you sure?
She's telling me everything in there that is what is
well,
the most up-to-date information.
That
no, she sent it to everyone. You guys were on copy of it. Did
no.
you not read it?
No, we did not get it.
I'm not sure.
I think the
there
on
so
there.
Many emails around today that everyone.
Yeah, I believe that you were on copy as well.
Income today.
But with all her projections, she's saying that we are down $10,000 with Raleigh, and she didn't have the numbers for team.
Well, so we also go back, Denise, to if we are down, if we are down campers, you know,
that becomes a, also a staffing. So right now,
right.
if we're overstaffed, then that should be able to be figured out with hours worked. We have a lot of our counselors who are taking weeks off for vacation, so I don't know if that's been projected in.
Kelly was copied on it, not you, Jerry.
I accept your apology.
I'm not apologizing. I'm just saying Kelly was on it. So I'm not here to hide you guys. I'm just here to saying we have to make a decision whether or not.
So you want to cancel Camp Raleigh as well?
No, that's not what I said.
Okay. Well, you see.
But it has to have some reductions in it to make it neutral for the revenue.
My concern.
So glad you're for the kids.
My concern is we have not heard. We're maybe $10,000 in debt. But I know we've got $3,000 or so out in grant money.
Mm-hmm.
And we will not hear until June 15th at the earliest. And then two of them we will hear in July, maybe, and one in August.
So all I'm saying is that you have to probably have one field trip or two field trips. And if you get that money, you can have it. You can have it at the end of the program and not at the beginning of the program. But there has to be modifications on here.
So here's my issue. My issue is we redid the program last year. One of the biggest concerns was offering a safe educational program that would benefit the kids in town that would also remain affordable.
Mm-hmm.
So if you try to put all of those things in a nutshell, it almost can't be done. So, you know, we went from a very heavily funded town program that was 80, 90% 2 years ago to now you want it to be revenue neutral, and I don't know, I find a bit of a concern about that. And honestly, I pay taxes in this town, and you know, this is a concern for me, what my tax money is going to, because I feel this is a program that our town needs.
Mm-hmm.
And it's upsetting that I'm hearing you say the bottom line is this. We gotta be, you know, revenue neutral. That, you know,
we were surprised though.
But we were told, I thought, given a little leeway for a program to evolve into being revenue neutral. Not 1 year evolution.
I believe that Suzanne has stated that it needs to be revenue neutral from the beginning. And I know that you came short last year.
But not $10,000.
You don't have the numbers you had last year.
We are very close to our numbers. We have 70 kids, I believe, right now.
Okay.
So we had 78 last year.
Then, well, you also gave huge raises.
Yeah.
That's eating out of your money. So that in itself, I don't even understand how you came to those raises, to be honest with you. So
because they offer $10 an hour in South Berwick, so to have competent counselors who are watching our kids for a full day, you gotta pay kids $10 an hour.
But they're being paid more than that.
There's a couple of them. Most of them, the majority of them are
wanted something.
10.
They had to be over 16,
mm-hmm.
50% ratio over 18. The 18-year-olds are not gonna take $9 an hour when they can go work in McDonald's for 11.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, we're just trying to stay competitive.
Everybody came
all.
Back.
Yeah. Stay competitive.
So what would you like to fix in the program?
I wish to you
revenue
to
if she said a bit more.
Well, I just think that Tina is still, I'm not sure what we're going to be able to do with Tina. But this one here, Raleigh, is, we're not canceling it, and I put that in my email, we were not canceling it.
Well. That's an email I didn't get once again.
Well, the rec department did. It went to the rec department, so you did get it.
I can't.
If you're on the rec department's distribution list. So, but
It said it wasn't going to be canceled, but there might be some modification in programming. So if you get the grants, then you don't have to have a modification if that subsidizes whatever it's supposed to subsidize. So, but we may have to cancel a field trip and have something in-house. You're still gonna have the program. So, I mean, the biggest problem is the bus. That issue.
Oh, I know.
So unless you, I mean, if you're talking about 70 kids, it's not like you can get cars for transportation.
We wouldn't do that.
Yeah, you have to have a bus.
We wouldn't do that for Camp Raleigh.
What if we talk to the director and have her set up for the first week or something? We have done before, like the Wentworth House, and do something that doesn't require a bus. And that would cut out.
Make them just stay at camp the first week and get used to everybody.
Or if we have to cut another field trip, they can go up to the Wentworth House. It's walking for those that want to go. And then that saves on travel.
The Wentworth House expected money last year.
Yes. So and their minimum is $100.
Yeah.
So that is far less.
You go to the library for free.
Yeah. But I'm thinking those could be some of our programming concessions to reduce costs.
Right.
And instead of going on a hike off grounds or whatever, or to a state park, they could hike the Scout Lanes, which is right here in town. Mm-hmm. And the kids go during the school year from the elementary school through the Scout Lanes and back. So it's not anything that even the first graders are unfamiliar with or unable to do, because the first graders came from kindergarten where they do that on a weekly basis. Mm-hmm. So it's not like we're expecting the kids to do more than they're capable of by making some simple programming changes that will reduce the costs.
Right. Yeah, I mean, we just have to think outside the box right now.
And along the those lines, in this budget, some of the activities fees
that will go low.
That will go lower if we don't have as many kids.
Right.
Because those are based on numbers 15. Of 20,
mm-hmm.
15 to 20.
Mm-hmm.
So the activities budget is going, for outgoing costs, is going to fall probably in half if we only have 10 kids going. And for some of the more expensive activities, we may have smaller groups. And there are other activities that I've researched and put out to the directors and stuff that could reduce it even more. So there are ways that we can feasibly reduce the activities line in the team budget to bring it down. There are ways that we can physically alter. We're in a workshop over the rec.
Okay.
So join us.
Grab a seat.
There are ways that we can simply reduce the budget lines for Camp Raleigh. That'll bring us down until we get confirmation all the money's in and get verification.
Would it be possible to get this budget revised to reflect what you're talking about?
Right.
Based on the numbers that you have?
And based on the numbers that you have and the amount of students you have and the staff you have. And do you need all the staff if you have lower numbers? That's
because if you could present a clearer picture, that might alleviate the problem.
Right. So where are we at?
We were just reviewing the budget for both
that we're in 10,000 hold
with Camp Raleigh, based on your numbers.
But Celia was saying that some of the activity fees will go down because you have fewer students. Some of the staff can be reduced. Yes. So that some of the expenses will go down where the income has gone down. So if we can see that based on the numbers you have, then that would be helpful.
So I guess Kelly, if you, or if somebody can send me the numbers, I can rework them because I have it at home.
Yeah.
I have all the activities in a spreadsheet, and I can, if you can send me by week how many teen campers there are, I can work out the price for the activities and add it all up for you.
Part of the concern is that we're late in the game to be like in this situation. So if it has to get canceled, people need to know that so they can make other arrangements and we can get them refunds. Or there has to be a revision that placates the board in time so that that decision doesn't have to be made. I think it's just about how quickly can we turn it around and get a new picture so the board can.
Are you talking about teen or camp Bowen?
It's actually both. Like I would think because they affect each other. So teen camp's the big one. Is it getting canceled or isn't it? If you can present a different picture, then maybe it doesn't have to be. But that has to happen quickly, because it needs to get refunded or move forward, and we need a path.
So just so because I'm coming in, where are we now with teen camp? Like how many registrations do we have?
Do you want to see this number
that is? So we have 10 on the box.
Yeah, there's one can access. Yeah, it's in the box somewhere.
I can get it tomorrow.
So we have another one extra. So potentially, so we have 10 campers for the first week. There are two at a time, so 8 Raleigh people.
So what's the revenue for that?
So $1,130. So this is the revenue across the board here. So the revenue right now is $4,660. For the whole summer, what we would need to pay our person is that is roughly $2,550.
So you're looking at $1,128 in the end.
And we have $2,122, but this kills us.
The bus is
$3,250.
So we've talked about insurance and that the driver of a vehicle can
potentially
take on people and drive them on the field trips versus a bus, but they have to have liability insurance. Does that copy need to be at the town hall?
Yes,
I would say absolutely, just like it is at the grade school.
So you have to provide.
Which means you have to be working on who's going to volunteer to do that and provide your certificates of insurance and valid driver's license now.
So how come you don't do that with basketball?
You could, I suppose. If it's a town event and the board approves the idea, then I still need to check it with the insurance company, but it should work,
right? That's why you need to meet there, right? Even if it's up outside.
Right, so
you're not going to.
Well, but you go to games off site, potentially.
But you don't take a bus, do you?
No.
No,
so that's why you don't go to basketball.
Parents.
Volunteers. Parents working with parents.
So you're not going there. And then as a group going somewhere. I think that's the difference.
Mm-hmm. So we discussed that they need to have a field trip waiver, needs to go into the teen camp folder, saying that they can ride with somebody that's not a bus driver.
But will be
insured
license and
driver.
Documentation sent to town.
Waiver, insured, license.
Well, driver. I wonder at this point, too, if we have, like right now, I'm looking at weeks 4 and 6, or do we, those have 3 people? Like, do we just say, now, like,
you can cancel that week.
Cancel weeks 3 and 6 because
of the numbers. There's a savings there.
And then you reduce your staff costs and all your
costs.
Activities and buses in those 3 weeks.
I don't know what to do. I'm slightly disappointed with their numbers myself. So,
what about this is a part of an education process for me. Mm-hmm. So at this point, we can't really just trying to become neutral. Mm-hmm.
They have to be for both because of we don't have any flexibility in the town bus to take on the 10 that's already outstanding for Raleigh and whatever they're having on here. So we need to modify the program if they're going to maintain the program. We're not saying we won't maintain 15, but it's got to, you got to do something somewhere in that. And if it's a field trip every once a week to cover, that's what we got to do. But it's got to happen quickly before we.
Can I make a suggestion that? So week 3, there's only one. No. Sorry, I'm reading that
one. Go down.
Check the other way. So 4 and 6. And Dee, we've already brought the budget down a little bit for teen based on removing the second counselor and the, we're hiring the assistant director at a lower cost. So we have a new bottom line for expenditures. Which Kelly figured out.
Are you all accounting for payroll taxes?
Yeah, it wasn't a budget.
Yes.
Like when you're paying people.
It wasn't a budget.
Payroll taxes right now is set at $300.
So
yeah, she had it set.
So it's probably less than that.
It's 7.65% of whatever you're paying people. So you can figure it out and make sure that since you're reducing your salaries, mm-hmm. reduce your payroll or adjust so that you've got.
And I sent, this is a budget that I had worked out for a grant, and I sent earlier a copy to the chairs with some of the, what I want to say, reductions in it. So let me just see if I can pull up, here we go, what the reductions were. But I can certainly forward that on. I do know I've reduced the activities and the transportation costs, and Kelly's saying that it may even be less than this. And if we reduce those 2 weeks, we could be better. But
well, there's also too on that, and you know, you got to play with the day too. Like bus, if you go a half day of the bus, that's, you know, half the expense too. Or you do one day of bus. And
did you guys have any luck this week with buses or transportation?
Yeah,
there's vans or anything like that.
Yeah.
So we discussed before you got here, as long as it was the owner driving, like Kelly can drive her 15 passenger van, mm-hmm. but she has to provide the certificate of insurance and a driver's license, and then we need the waiver. So that could eliminate the bus, like the first week when they go, because, but it has to
but be. But somebody else cannot drive her car.
Yeah,
right.
It has
and
to be her.
Right,
so it strictly has to be you, and then you have to be available now all
right.
summer.
Right.
Which means you can't work.
Yeah, which isn't happening, so. I mean, I can do it a couple times, but.
What about,
well, and doing it a couple times, though, will reduce the expenses.
Mm-hmm. It's the whole picture, not just the,
yeah.
by the week.
Right.
Right.
So if you can potentially eliminate the really low participation mm-hmm. weeks,
so
you might just be where you need to be.
Right.
Can I make a motion then?
No.
So
it's a
motion. Can I make a suggestion that we eliminate weeks with less than 5 campers?
Do you know if those weeks are the people that are there for the like the whole summer, or don't
yes.
we know?
We have one person signed up for all 7 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So that person would be affected.
And
sorry.
The other person is signed up for 5 weeks, and the other person is signed up for 6 weeks.
So if you reduce the program by that week, then that person is also going to expect to have reimbursement.
Right. Back.
And so we have to prorate and figure out what that is.
Yep. Yep. Compared to what it's costing for that week.
Right.
And those are out of town residents.
Well, what do you mean prorate?
Because it would be a flat.
Whatever your cost is by day, right?
Well, we just have to figure out whatever. So it depends on what the structure is for how they signed up. Did they pay by the week, or
That's the only way you can do that for this camp.
Then
yeah.
you pay, you know, whatever amount times 6 weeks
mm-hmm.
or times 8 weeks
mm-hmm.
or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
So you can figure out what the weekly rate is, and they
right.
will get that times however many weeks you're canceling.
Right, right.
So that
but you still
you want to cancel.
It's going to be $345 would be taken off of income.
And then what would your expense be? Quite a bit, because you have
that would be
3 buses, right?
Yeah, that would be
up
to grand.
6 buses.
Right?
Because
no.
they go.
No.
No.
4 buses. So it would be $2,000. So it would be in the plus there.
Dee, can you tell
six,
me,
90,
or Jody,
grand,
any of the team
six,
campers,
90.
Since we made the announcement that there's pre and post, would they be getting a refund on pre and post, too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
They all signed up for pre and post, so that would better on
13, 10. So I have to reimburse that too.
Because I only accounted for $250 for pre and post, which is one camper. It's like 8 to 10 weeks of pre and post. So we may be bringing in more money with pre and post than we have
predicted. So when can we have an updated budget that reflects that and the possibility of reducing the two least amount of participants? When can we have an updated one to see if we're in the ballpark?
Is this with, are you saying this is when, if we canceled out those 2 weeks, is that, okay.
Yep, and the updated on pre and post, and the reduction of the...
buses and stuff.
And the reduction of the counselor, is that what you said? A reduction of the...
whatever the associated
counselor
expenses.
So that's 2650, right? So...
and you wanted updated activity fees, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you switching activities?
Well, if
we only have 10 tickets that we have to buy.
But we projected based on
15
or 20.
So that changes the big time as well.
I mean, I can sit down and work on it tonight as well and get it back to you tomorrow.
Yeah, because I mean,
why don't you and I try and do that together? So why don't we talk about
and D probably have some numbers too.
4, I don't think.
13?
No. No, Kelly, you have.
Yeah.
Unless you handed me some that had D in it.
I did, but I have accounted for that already.
Okay. Then no, I don't have anything additional.
Just the one in the box.
So if Kelly and I get you the updated numbers that show we're coming in revenue neutral.
And it's on.
It's on.
Okay.
And if we can...
or if it's really, really close to revenue neutral, then I think we can go with it. But it's got to be... I can't tell you what then because I have to see where Raleigh is right now.
Okay. So if we can get that to you tomorrow...
It will be in the afternoon or evening.
That's okay.
And then we can let families know
finances
by Wednesday.
Number of registrations.
The latest.
Yeah.
Well,
absolutely. Does that make you more comfortable?
It does.
And I'm wondering if we should let those three campers know about weeks 4 and 6, like ASAP, or should we just hold off and wait to see if we can pull this off and then...
Well, I don't think we're going to have... I wouldn't think that we were going to be able to have the ones with the 3 or 4 in the weeks only.
Yeah.
Regardless, I think you're going to have to eliminate that one altogether. Yeah.
But I would suggest that you hold off notification until the board decides that it's not canceled altogether.
Altogether, right.
Right, right.
Okay.
So that you're not sending out two
mm-hmm.
bad news things.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The same kind of. I'm not sending that email. I'm not. That's why I stepped up on board.
Does Katie need a background check?
I spoke to the police chief. He's going to run a local one in New Hampshire.
Okay.
And so she's going to call the police department and arrange for that.
Did she come in and talk to you too?
Yes.
And 52
and hours like in here earlier?
Yes.
Okay. She, we had a long conversation yesterday. She came to watch my daughter's soccer game, and she has some really awesome ideas. So she's, you know, worked with kids for a long time. She was one of the counselors at York. So she's like, you know, if we get to stay and we got to do this, and I don't know. You know, she just seemed like...
She's very innovative and positive.
Yes.
Is she Raleigh or team?
Team.
She's the team.
Okay.
Yeah, she's awesome. So it would really...
Why is it that we can't utilize the school's credit reference? Why do we have to get them done all over again for here?
So she's a York...
Not necessarily her, in general.
Like me, I am fingerprinted and stuff through the school. If I want to volunteer at Camp Raleigh, do I...
I don't think that's the case. So I defer all those questions to Bob, but if they've been done through the school and it's been recently, he would say it's fine. in recent conversations, that's what I would say he would say, is that she's fine. Or if it was a few years ago, he might do a local search.
Okay. But that would be done here, not through state police.
Correct.
Yeah.
He can do that.
Yeah. Okay. That's good.
Because she's a high school teacher, so clearly she's been...
Well, right, but that was 11 years ago that she was hired and did that. So that's why he's going to run her in New Hampshire, because a lot can happen in 11 years, he said. So, and not, it wasn't done here.
So does that cost us if he runs it?
Not for local, only when you go through the state police.
So it won't cost us anything, so we might as well just give him peace of mind.
Yeah.
Right.
Because the other one is through the state police, and that's what's costing us, right?
$47.
Yeah.
So are we set on teen?
We are set that there's a plan.
There's a plan.
And get the numbers and update your budget, and we will see how it looks, and then we will make a decision right away.
Are any of the grants specific to teen camp?
We have written in, not totally, two or three of the grants we've written in $500 to expand programming and doing rainy day activities. So Blitz Air Park, we only budgeted $20, and it costs $3 for the socks and $17 an hour. So if they go to Blitz Air Park, that's one of those that would be a half-day trip instead of a full-day trip, so we could save on bus. And they could come back here and do something in the afternoon based on the director's discretion versus going out and getting ice cream or something.
So the point of my question, though, is that if we receive funds for a specific purpose, we have to use it for that purpose. Mm-hmm. So if it denotes special different programming, if that language is vague and can enhance Raleigh, that's one thing. But if it's really specific to teen camp and how you wrote the proposal, then there would be some kind of problem that we would have to work out with accepting those funds for a specific program that's been canceled, if it's canceled.
So,
True.
We said for teen camp to expand the Blitz Air Park and to do rainy day activities such as movies. The other teen camp items were budgeted. The one grant covered the STEM in the summer through UNH is grades 4 through 10, so it covered both camps. And then Chris, the trick bike rider, covers K through 12, so those grants would go.
I just think that for any grant monies that we receive, we need to go back to the language of the grant to see what the stipulations are, because there are always strings and stipulations, and we need to make sure that we're meeting whatever reporting requirements and or conditions of the money.
And I have already spoken to at least one of the grantors, Eastern Bank, and they do not require any follow-up, but they do stipulate their money be used for what it's stated in the grant. And what I did with, in the past, when we received a local grant, was take pictures and have the person who did the program write a brief synopsis of how they thought it went. So I thought maybe if we could direct the camp staff to take pictures during the event, and either the person who came say, I had a great time, this is what I presented, or the camp administration do the same thing. Such and such a person came on such and such a date and presented to the camp, and then put them in the, I have a folder on the drive where it could all be stored. And so if it does come up, you didn't spend our money appropriately, as you said, we have the proof there.
I think it's also a good idea, if you receive funds, as a way of saying thanks and hoping for funds in the future, to document the experience that it paid for proof that it, you know, that the experience met the qualifications, but also, you know, as a show of gratitude for the funds, because that would be just a nice thing to do, and it would be helpful if you're going to ask for funds.
And
in
I know
the future.
It's just like REF, when REF gave you,
yeah,
that's
exactly
what we expect back.
And like we did with C&J last year, we sent them a t-shirt that was left over from Camp Raleigh that didn't fit any of the kids, and a thank you card with our tax ID number in it, and said thank you, and then we appreciate your donation. We look forward to working with you in the future. And as I've been going to local businesses soliciting funds based on our letter. I've put a note on some of them that have donated last year. I said, last year, we really appreciated your $25 gift card, or your $25 gift card bought water for our camp, mm-hmm. or something, so they know what they donated last year to.
Yeah.
You guys may have already talked about this, but what about the teen camp doing a state park with Camp Raleigh? Is that something that you probably wouldn't do in place of one of the trips?
I believe that we travel on the same days.
I thought Raleigh was going on Mondays.
But could you adjust the schedule so that could happen? Because that would save you money if it can work, if you can all fit on a bus.
And I know that was one of the things I put in my email. It's like, could we rearrange camp from teen camp to go to Camp Raleigh?
I think, and I wasn't sure when Brittany or how many days she's doing that with, I haven't seen her schedule of our field trips.
And that would also increase, if we could combine the two camps going on field trips, it would reduce our bus costs, and we already have the 15, I believe, state park passes.
Yes.
So it would allow them maybe to go to, may not cause as many reductions in Camp Raleigh if we do them together. Because then they could go. One week it would come out of team budget, one week it would come out of Camp Raleigh or whatever it's designated.
So they're going on Mondays from the state park.
Right from the first day?
No, they're only going to go 7 weeks, so they're skipping the first week.
So it's Monday, Friday? Mm-hmm. For field trip?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, that might be a need then. We should be able to adjust the schedule for that.
The first week, you'll still need two buses.
Right.
So that's the busiest week.
Even the teen camp, they didn't all fit on the bus last
year. I mean, for the regular camp.
Yes, yeah, right. They didn't all fit on the bus last year.
That's
they had
everybody
ride
showed
with,
up.
Damn. So, well, the first week is... I might be attending both of those teams.
She mentioned she was going to get the bigger buses, and I think they... No, is it the bigger... Is it 75 or 90 for the
90
bigger?
Is the bigger bus.
She mentioned last meeting she's been trying to get the bigger ones at all times.
Right. And that first week we had.
Okay, so the plan is that you're going to look at your budget, you're going to revise it as you can, you're going to look at your revenue, and you're going to see where you come out with the revised program, possibly canceling the lowest enrollment weeks of teen, and see where we come out. Correct?
So, so Kelly, as far as the, I'm going to go back to the state park thing.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have to be the first week that you guys go to them, because you know how numbers dwindle as you go down. So maybe one of the other weeks, mid to late or something. That might help.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was already going on the Wednesday trip, because we're short our counselor. So that was me.
So Denise, plan for teen camp. Revise budget, income, and expenditures to confirm revenue neutral.
Mm-hmm. What is the expectation, though, if you do go with people driving their own vehicles? There's going to be an expense to that, right?
Not necessarily, you know.
Well, do you want to be
involved?
Volunteer.
Willing to do
it's
that
a volunteer.
At their own expense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Surprised.
Make sure you're thinking of
but that. If you're going to cut your expenses planning on that, you've got to know that you've got that many people willing
to
do it. So that you're not making a further revision later and you have to go to the field trip because you couldn't find enough parents to do that.
Okay. All right, so. Well, it sounds like we can cut our bus money in half, is what I'm seeing. Just these two ideas, which is really what we need to do.
Hooking on to Raleigh's.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
It's a 73 people bus.
Which one?
Just the large one is a 73.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So how many numbers are we total?
For Raleigh right now?
For
so
both.
Right now it's 68 for Raleigh.
When they're little kids. Yes.
Oh, 3 to a seat.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so how many, sorry?
68 for Raleigh right now, I'm not sure.
Okay, and how many for teen at the most?
11.
10 on the first day, first week.
But we have one in the box.
The phantom box.
Could be 11.
Oh, okay, so that's close, mm-hmm. that we could utilize that bus.
That's why we ran over last year. We ran out of space.
Because not everybody goes on the first week, so it depends on what our counts are for the first week, too.
Mm-hmm. And not,
which I haven't dived into.
And registration isn't ended yet either. Mm-hmm. And like mine is in process. It's up on my computer. And I will be attending my son will be attending the first week, so there'll be more coming.
What I do know is that there was not 68 attending the first week, because I did a quick scan of it, and there's a good 10 maybe that aren't going to be there the first week.
So is that also a pay by week? Raleigh is also?
It is.
Mm-hmm. It can be.
It can be.
You can do one or the other.
Do you save money if you do it a week at a week?
You save money if you buy all 8 weeks, once you hit 5 weeks. Okay.
Yeah.
If you're doing 5 weeks or less, it's cheaper to pay the $60 for residents. And it's $80, I think, for out of town. But once you hit the 5 week, it's a better deal to buy all 8. And I had a parent come to me last week, I just signed my kid up for 2 weeks, but he's already somewhere else, and he's already signed up for Camp Raleigh. You think I should ask for a refund? I'm like, you could try. And then I thought about it, I'm like, you're probably already saving money now, so leave it as it is.
Okay, so I will wait and see what we get from you tomorrow, and we will make a decision based on that. But it sounds like it's going to be okay if we can do these reductions or modifications to the program.
Okay, so can we go back to the... We had a little discrepancy, Dee, before you got here. On Camp Raleigh, we understand that there's a big deficit, and your numbers show that deficit. Does your numbers reflect everything that's projected to come in throughout the summer? Because we have...
Wait, what do you mean for... No, not everything. No, not sales, not...
No, but does it reflect, if you have 10 registrations, are they paid in full according to your income?
Yeah.
Or are they... Okay.
Yeah, so 68, we've got 68 paid in fulls that's reflected. Yes,
because you're counting all the money, whether or not you have it yet. Because
Sports Engine was partial payments, so yeah. She wanted Jody asked if you were considering all of that. So you're taking a camper and your times it about the amount of weeks that they're doing, even if you haven't got the funds yet.
That's right. Yeah,
that's right.
Full tuition, whatever we've gotten from them is what's reflected here. So Sports Engine is short because we still have a bunch of paper registrations are not even in there yet. So I have a whole spreadsheet based on that too.
But I don't. Short? Do you mean numbers wise? So more than 68?
Like next week is the next payment. Mm-hmm. Are you reflecting the next 4 payments that are coming in already?
Yeah, I went through and I added up everything that they had placed their order for.
Okay.
So their complete order has been accounted for.
Okay.
Minus the processing service fees, since we don't get those anyways. I wish. But yeah, so everything's accounted for.
So like those registrations that I'm just handing you, that's not your 68, right?
No.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So we
that's additional.
No, what's included is the Sports Engine, the paper registrations, and Roxanne's, unless Roxanne's is here.
Roxanne is one of those. Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, I'm sorry, Roxanne's is there.
Is it Blyce in there?
Yeah, I got Blyce in there too.
Okay.
So anything above that?
Yeah, one more.
So.
Actually, I have 2 more.
Dee, I got your PDFs for what people paid for Team Camp that went through Sports Engine. I'm holding on to those. But if we know, you know, we'll wait until there's a final determination about Team Camp, but if we are only refunding some people for some weeks, I need some other kind of piece of paper to document what they are owed and that they paid something to begin with. Actually, I have the receipt that they paid something to begin with, so that's not the issue, but I need some kind of documented formula to calculate out what they're owed so that when I run their refunds, I have documentation for that.
Jody, do you want to do that or do you want me to do that?
Nope.
You don't want to do that?
Nope.
Are you refusing to do anything? So you can't.
No, I'll put it. I'm afraid that you're going to cancel these 2 weeks, and the people that are signed up are going to just pull their kid altogether because they're here all summer. And if they're anything like me as a working parent, I can't take another 2 weeks off. So they'll just put them somewhere else.
Well, you know what? Well, what we can also do, how about this, before we cancel those 2 weeks, we can still run some numbers with adjoining
Raleigh.
So we can do 2 things tomorrow with that.
Does Sports Engine have any language, or do your registrations have any language about what is refundable or what is not refundable?
No, just that the refund is available up until June 1st, I think.
Boards are canceling it. You have to get everything.
I think we just need to work that into next year's registration, all the documentation that we need to be explicit about what is refundable up until what point, and then what is not refundable. For example, processing fees for Sports Engine. Mm-hmm. You know, if we are canceling some or part of any of this, what does that mean for credit card processing fees that people paid? Mm. People are going to be upset with that on either side. So,
In Sports Engine. Sports Engine does cover that.
They cover that?
In their little disclaimer, like, processing fees are not part of blah, 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 blah. That's in the...
So they don't cover that. So,
right? You are, yeah.
Can you send me that language or like a screenshot or something?
Sure.
That would be helpful.
We need to look into options for low attendance weeks at Camp Raleigh, or at teen camp, to see if they can join Camp Raleigh, right?
Raleigh.
Okay.
So your numbers here are based on what you knew this morning. So to say you have a couple there.
Last night, yeah.
Okay, or last night. So potentially there is some more revenue that might come in on that. But according to the spreadsheet, we're down, we're in the hole for 10,007.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you had said there's some potential expense reductions of 6362. Is that with all of them? A, B, C, D, E?
Yep, that's all.
Okay. So, what are your recommendations for? So, scenario A is state parks cost for 7 weeks reduced to 4 state parks, and that would have a savings of $658. That's scenario one.
Right, so right now there's 7 state parks.
Trips.
Yeah.
7 weeks, yeah.
We reduced it to 4. That saves us $658. We did that.
Yeah.
If we...
How much was the
savings?
$658.
And is that just for transportation?
It must be in, because your park tickets are the price of the same.
Yeah,
regardless.
So that's strictly bus costs.
Okay. So B is saying, upon close of registration, possible staff reduction due to a staff camper ratio versus number of campers per week, potentially $2,000 to $3,000 savings.
And it's really no different than what we did last year. We realized we had so many staff. You know, as the summer goes by, that
when kids drop off and they, you know, it's one of those situations where you sign up for 8 weeks and you're really only there five.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and what Celia just told you is that it's cheaper to pay for your 8 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And you may only be going 5 or 6.
No, you're
going
to take a week or two vacation on your own.
Right. So they were letting staff go because of that reason, but I won't really have a clearer picture until after all the registrations are in,
mm-hmm.
what the count is. So, I mean, we could possibly, at week 4, 5, 6, and 7, let's just say, have too many on staff
mm-hmm.
for what we have.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, then we're considering a staff reduction, which is great for us.
Mm-hmm.
But, so I won't know until I get the numbers and then mm-hmm. I talk to Brittany. And make sure her and I are aligned with the ratios and staff.
So when you hire the staff people, are they advised that that's a possibility?
I didn't do the hiring, so I'm not really sure if they get...
They don't actually take off. Like, if they're hired full-time, they're not working full-time anyway. So the people that were hired full-time, they actually took weeks off.
Yeah.
And we have had 4 requests already.
Right.
And 3... possibly have already been given, and the 4th one's in question, the week after July 4th, from July 9th to July 13th, or something like that. So we have already had several staff ask for that week off, and
okay, and these are things that I don't know, so I kind of need to know these things so that I can account for them.
So
that's,
and one of them is the assistant director for Camp Raleigh will be out that week, and then 2 other staff will be out, and another staff member asked, but if
you need to pull that, you need, Brittany has that information. So when she did that initially, you know, I'm sure she's gone through everybody with what their family, because I know my relatives that they have certain weeks that they're, you know, taking off too. So there's definitely reduction in staff anyway, but Brittany has that information.
Okay, so but we must have enough staff members to cover.
That's why Brittany said to the 4th person, you're the 3rd or 4th person to request that week off. You have to wait until we get our camp numbers finalized before we allow you to take that week.
Okay, so we don't have a vacation. I don't think there's a choice.
So we know Janessa's calling
at these ages.
We sort of queued up to be able to take that.
And you need to follow up with the camp director for more information.
Okay. So there's numbers off the top already. So
yeah.
That's good.
Yep.
Not to mention registrations. We always get last minute registrations.
Mm-hmm.
We could very well hit 78, which is another.
Somebody already asked me if we took late registrations.
Somebody
asked if we took late registrations.
And if you remember, we had people sign. We had 4 people sign up
mid-year.
But the last 4 weeks.
Yeah. Mid-year.
They're like, can we come? And
We had space.
So.
Yep. So what is the setup training about? What is that?
So she does 1 week of training, 1 day of training and 1 day of setup is what she has set up.
Okay,
here.
And training?
For the counselors.
Of the do's and don'ts and
mm-hmm.
okay.
So going over
it's
the parent handbook and
okay.
all that kind of stuff.
So
okay.
She gave us a date, and I believe it was yesterday, June 10th. That she met and did an all-day training with her staff at the grade school, and then they are going to have a partial day when the school does CPR and first aid. Those
mm-hmm.
that they were, each of them were trained last year, half in CPR, half in first aid. This year they're going to swap, so the ones that were trained in first aid will get CPR, and the ones that were trained in CPR
mm-hmm.
will get first aid, so they're trained in both,
mm-hmm.
and that will happen when the school does it. And last year we didn't account for costs for that because we thought the fire department was going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was a snafu that the person that does the training with the fire department was unavailable. So we, I believe, have incurred that cost in the budget this year to do the training for the school.
Okay, we have 300 budget.
Okay, so.
And then they're gonna do a setup.
Setup is to get all the stuff ready for camp the following day, so that takes time.
All right, and the expectation is everyone gets paid during these processes, right?
That's
and we worked
law.
It out in one
That's
of our
the
meetings.
Law.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
All right, so.
So I didn't realize that had already happened, but what I was thinking is for the setup, I didn't know if in order to reduce hours, if she wanted to ask for volunteer help to do that as well, but I don't know, that's something I need to talk to her about.
And.
Well, that's where we all come in.
At the last meeting, it was requested that they do a meet and greet with the counseling staff. So I'm guessing that the counselors will be paid for that, and I think that's the Friday before counseling.
Pay for a meet and greet?
No, I think they're piggybacking that.
Well, all right, so to be clear, anything that you require employees to do, you have to pay them for, whether it's training or whatever it is. If you're requiring them to be there, you have to pay them for it.
So if they had meet and greet that it was optional, then you don't have to pay them?
If you create it as optional, then, you know, and you're clear that you're not getting paid to go, and you're welcome to go if you want to go, but don't expect them to show up. And as long as you're black and white, it's probably okay.
Mm-hmm.
But you're not allowed to volunteer to do your day job.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's an opportunity to be exploited.
Mm-hmm.
So you just have to plan for that. Whatever you're asking people to do, you know, with the director before the season starts, everything, all the hours, they have to be recorded and paid.
Okay. So if we could just go back for a minute. Recommendations, I have A and B. Have we jumped into C yet?
No, that is a question before we go there.
Okay.
I had an email from Brittany asking about pre-camp for her and the assistant director. And if I read this correctly, it was 12 hours for the director and 5 hours for the assistant, is that correct? Or did I misinterpret that?
Yeah, so right, I talked to Brittany 2 days ago. She had already put in 10 hours.
Yep.
The expectation of putting in a few more.
Right.
And Janessa had already put in 4, the expectation of maybe putting in another hour.
Okay, because I had, based on this, I had replied to her and said that you have a cap of 12 and your assistant has a cap of 5. Was that correct in saying that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay,
that's fine.
Okay. So she's probably going to come and do a sheet of whatever, and if you need me to sign it, I will, because I told her we would pay for her already for what she has put in.
What I would suggest for the two of them, where they've worked those hours
mm-hmm.
probably over many weeks,
mm-hmm.
is to do it by email and submit the hours via email.
Okay.
And you can either by email reply that you approve it, or else send it to one of these people
mm-hmm.
and first for their approval
mm-hmm.
and then for your approval. But to do separate time cards might be like 3 or 4 time cards, and that's just
yeah. No, that doesn't make sense. The email's fine if you're accept
yeah.
if you'll accept
an
email.
With that.
Yeah. Okay. I can send that to them. Because I don't know who referred, but they referred her to me for the answers. So that's why.
Okay.
So anyway, that was my interpretation of this here. So that's what I told her.
Mm-hmm.
And the counselors did not have any pre-camp. It's just the director and the assistant, right?
Right. That we know of.
That we
yeah.
Know.
So that
okay.
setup
that
and training
have.
Day was not budgeted to be paid. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
No,
budgeted.
It is in there.
Yeah.
It
okay.
is in there, but it's different than this.
Okay.
This is stuff that they've been working on, I'm assuming.
Right.
Throughout
mm-hmm.
since
yeah,
they started for this
yeah,
year,
yeah,
they're so they're putting,
and
yeah,
they're
planning.
Exactly.
So they would. This was budgeted.
Yeah.
And
the training is a separate line for the
right.
Okay.
Training and orientation, which they have all staff, including directors, 14 hours each. That's is that really 14
that's what
hours?
They budgeted for was 14 hours.
Is that
what we had budgeted for originally is 14 hours? Yeah.
Is
which
that but is
two
necessary?
Days.
Is 14 is. That's
well,
not,
I,
I'm just
that
curious.
Was my thought. What, see, again, I didn't know that she had already done the training, so that's
mm.
a move forward, you know, the 7 hours.
Because when you make the budget, you don't know who's coming back yet.
True.
We're lucky that
so
we have
true.
Everybody
so
coming
they
back.
Have
yeah.
less
so
less
training.
Training
this year.
So I
last
suggested
year.
To her, well, why don't you just, if you can do setup,
mm-hmm.
Maybe consider just doing it via volunteer. Because if you look at it, you're paying, so it's $124 an hour, all staff combined.
Mm-hmm.
So if we can knock off 124 times 7 hours,
mm-hmm.
I mean, that's a substantial savings right there. And there's no reason why we as volunteers or other volunteers.
The RIC committee did a great job setting up last year, and there'll
mm-hmm.
be less to set up and clean out.
because we cleaned out the shed and now it's organized.
Mm-hmm.
And so now it's just a matter of organizing the teacher's lounge and putting up the easy ups.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm afraid I won't be here, but hopefully we can get other volunteers.
Okay, yeah, so there's a potential savings of a little bit on the training and orientation.
Now, I have a question about that. I know last year we counted training and orientation, and then we took July 3rd and 4th, which were days off for camp, and threw them into training. Was that, did we think about putting, was July 4th counted?
July 4th is in the budget, yes.
So that's another 7 hours that we could push over to training, or that none of them are working, because July 4th camp is closed.
Camp is closed on July 4th,
right.
So why would we move the money to training? Just use it as a savings.
Okay. When we had figured out the budget, we mm-hmm. set that as a 5-day. So there's
1 day of
yes.
all staff that
yep,
you control another savings.
Right.
Which is,
you know, and quite honestly, I don't think I reflected that in here.
Yeah.
So it's going to be different. There's going to be a reduction there too.
Good. Okay, that's good news.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the only holiday. Yes.
That's the only holiday all of them will be off.
I know. We need a few more.
We certainly do. Okay. So, scenario D, Jenny Thompson pool costs for 8 weeks, $4.
Well, I think that's wrong. I just found out from Brittany. I think they're charging us, is it
$3?
It's only $3.
Okay.
So that's going to be a little less. But the overall picture for the Jenny Thompson trips is, using $4, which is wrong,
mm-hmm.
$2,700 for the whole summer. And so I didn't know if we wanted, I mean, if we can find savings elsewhere, which it sounds like we're not doing too bad of a job,
mm-hmm.
we may not have to consider cutting down the Jenny Thompson pool.
Mm-hmm.
But we could also, what about team camp doing the pool? Is that something you guys
They're
are
already going.
They are?
Yeah, that's their Friday trip.
Sorry.
They're going to be there with you.
So did you count them in, did you count transportation for that one?
Yeah, they're going on your bus.
Okay.
So they're going on the Camp Raleigh bus.
It's not. Well, they are now, they weren't.
No.
We always were.
We always put two buses per week into camp, to teen camp.
Right.
So the Friday has always been joining Camp Raleigh.
Yeah. But if we needed to, let's just say if we needed to reduce it in half, if we decided to reduce it in half, that's a $1,400 savings for the summer. But I don't know if it even sounds like we need to go there.
So,
no.
You needed two buses to the pool?
No.
No,
so
two buses per week for teen camp because the third bus was already going to the pool.
Oh, that's what you're saying.
Okay. You needed a Monday, Wednesday bus, and then the bus for teen camp was already there. And it's so close that they can make two loops.
That's my point. That was
yeah.
where I was going. I was going to say, why can't we just have two
yeah.
separate trips? It's going to,
yeah.
you're paying for it anyway. You might as well just have two
so
trips. But you already talked about that. You already considered
Brittany,
that.
I already have
right.
the idea of the older kids can go with a couple of the counselors.
Yep.
And then the second round, because they can start swimming before the littler ones get there.
Get there.
So.
Yep.
Because they're so close.
Okay. All right.
Because the bus doesn't care where you go.
You right.
By the hour.
How many times? By the hour. Okay.
And it's in 15-minute increments, I found out.
Okay, and then the reduced tea order for Raleigh.
Well, I wasn't sure about this because I realized that we had ordered 175 t-shirts total between Raleigh and the teen camp. Is that right? It's 100. It was,
there are 50 for camp, teen camp.
Oh, you didn't need that.
And then there are possibly 125.
So, let me go back and look.
At this point, I don't think it's already gone to the printers.
Okay.
I don't know if we...
But isn't he and Jay paying for all
yes,
the t-shirts?
Yes.
So it's kind of a wash there. So.
And $250, I believe, is in the... I don't know if it's in there, but it's on the spreadsheet I have at home already put out from C&J, put into Teen Camp to cover those 50 t-shirts.
Okay. So we can figure out that one, too.
Okay.
And I did question that, too. I said, with the ones that we already have over left over from last year, do we really need this many t-shirts for Camp Raleigh?
I'm not sure why we ordered so many. We had a whole stockpile of...
the rationale I got was we'd rather order more up front now than have to order more later if we run out of certain sizes.
Okay. Only because it's cheaper to buy a bigger bulk than it is to buy a small bulk.
Or to run a second.
Well, right now, I'm just assuming it's $6 a shirt. Brittany was telling me she has no idea how much per t-shirt it is yet. But the order's gone to the printer.
I can check into that if you'd like. You can check in with Brittany and ask her to check in.
Yeah, she's going to let me know. But I just base this on $6 a t-shirt like we did last year.
That would be my guess. The emails I did get from the graphic designer is that there's a possibility Teen Camp could have been less expensive because they're a white shirt versus a colored shirt, and instead of having printing on front and back like Camp Raleigh, they're only printing, I think, Camp Raleigh on the back, but they're being tie-dyed by the camp staff.
Mm-hmm.
Good. So,
all right. So, we still have a little bit of time on Raleigh. Hopefully, we can bring in that.
Yeah,
that was the first day of camp. I'm sorry to interrupt.
June 25th.
Okay.
So yeah. 2 weeks away.
So I think right now we wouldn't even be comfortable making any solid recommendations until we get the numbers in. Mm-hmm. And I think really critical is going to be the ratios,
mm-hmm.
and finding out where we are then, and then making these changes that I just found out about the staffing,
mm-hmm.
the weeks off, and the July mm-hmm. holiday, and all that's going to factor in. So
yep.
maybe closer than we actually think.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. In worst case, maybe one or two potential field trips with throughout the program or something, if. Worst case.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. Yeah.
That kind of happened to us last year anyway. We had a couple of rain days that
mm-hmm.
we just stayed put.
But we had to make up for it.
Like,
but
yeah,
you had to do it because you had construction issues,
right,
didn't you?
Right, well, yeah. So
which supposedly this is not going to affect you. That's what they're saying, right? The construction this year.
Is that construction?
Yeah, they're replacing the roof of the annex.
Oh.
What else? They're doing a couple of things.
Ew.
Yeah, but the only one that I think would affect you is the roof over the annex.
Okay.
But you've talked to him, didn't you,
Sue? I spoke with Brittany about ensuring that Doodlebugs would be able to come in, and she said if she needs to, she will push Doodlebugs back until after the roof is done, stuff like that.
So wait, when is the roof being done?
I didn't get a date
this
from
summer.
Kate, but Kate Lucas told me in an email that they should be all set, that it shouldn't affect us.
Okay.
No, you might be have some rope-off area outdoors. That
yeah.
would be the only thing that I think that you might be affected by. You might have to be on the grass instead of the pavement or something like that, and be away from that work area.
Right, and that happened last year when they replaced the windows.
It's
they,
the flat roof. It's over the annex.
And they replaced windows last year on the annex, so there were areas with scaffolding roped off that they weren't allowed to use.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, which I would foresee that happening as well.
And if the grants come through, then we could potentially, instead of going on field trips, schedule those special activities to come in on those days, which would cut down on our transportation
mm-hmm.
costs.
Right, we just said something else. I think you might have to know that.
And I'm not sure, I don't believe Dee or Jody was at a meeting, or Denise was at a meeting, but one of our committee members said, instead of using STEM through the summer, which is a UNH student that comes in, this year also offers free STEM to come in and do science, technology, engineering, and math within different communities. And I know South Berwick Library takes advantage of that. They do it once a month. And that they could put us into contact with somebody at the Portsmouth Shipyard who could come in and do STEM for free, possibly. And that might be another activity alternative that could be on Camp Raleigh grounds
mm-hmm.
and reduce our costs.
Mm-hmm.
And that same committee member discussed they have a contact at the Children's Museum and that they could possibly get us on a tour of the shipyard, but I haven't heard anything more from that committee member, so I don't know. And the two
that would be a bus trip.
The two later mm-hmm. options are bus trips, which would cost us money.
Mm-hmm. Not bus trips. Okay, so
we'll have sponges in the pool.
revise this as much as we can in the next couple of days and then get back to me.
Sure.
On where we stand on Raleigh. And when is cut off?
Friday.
But we will take late if it comes through, is my understanding. Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's.
As long as it's paying full.
As long as it's paying full. Okay. So let's see what that does and see if we can bring down that dollar amount and if we have a little.
So am I keeping the sports engine open past the 15th?
Did we decide to do that anyways? Like a week pass or? It was one week after the meeting we talked and we thought we can keep it open like a week past that.
Because they have to pay in full.
Yeah.
Because they have to pay in full, is that what you're saying? And you have to.
Well, so. You have to, you cannot accept people on the first day who are not paid in full. You have to take balance payments on the first day or you're, you know.
Well, Sports Engine, their installments are into July, right?
Yes.
So as long as they're on a payment plan and they're making the payments and it works out in the end, that's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, they have to pay all the pre-care and post-care up front no matter what. The only thing that they can budget is their actual cost of the camp. Like $330 for the first child, $290 for the second child.
So do you have the option of being on a payment plan and then not paying? Or really it just keeps your...
It's a pending charge on your credit card till that day. Like it tells you, I'll show you.
Like if you look at your credit card statement, you can see it's listed and it hasn't
pending.
Come off yet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or your debit card in your bank statement, you can see it says pending charge.
Yeah.
I'll show you what mine is. You guys can keep talking.
So, just to clarify, no campers showing up on the first day with payment. They need to all be paid.
Well, if they're in a payment arrangement with Sports Engine, I guess that's one thing. But you shouldn't be, you know, people who are paying by check need to be paid in full by then. And even the Sports Engine thing, I think, would make the auditor really uneasy. Mm-hmm. He wanted people paid for or not coming, you know. Mm-hmm.
If you scroll down to the bottom.
So
what she's asking is, though, if we had someone who wanted to come in the first week for some reason and they had a check in hand, are we turning them away?
Mm-hmm. I think if they're coming that day and they have a check for whatever the balance due that day, mm-hmm. that's fine. But if they show up that day and they have a balance due and they're not through Sports Engine on a payment plan, you're turning them away.
But we're not taking any partial payments unless they're on Sports Engine, right?
Right.
So all
there
checks
is no,
are paid as well.
Everything is paid
so
in
that
full
shouldn't
except,
happen.
So that
right.
shouldn't happen. But
yeah. If you're paying by check, you're paying full when you're paying.
Okay, so if you have someone, you know, for something that just moved into town or whatever, and they want to join that week or that,
then
we're going to take
full.
It, right? As long as it's in full.
In full. That's
okay,
right.
Every
as long
week
as
that they're going to be there.
Yeah, everyone's in full.
Okay, and we're okay with that, right?
Yeah. Now, the director had expressed the idea of knowing a week to 10 days out that how many counselors we were needing, being able to figure out numbers. So. Do we have a deadline as a strict cutoff, like the Friday before to make sure that, or the Wednesday before, absolutely no more? Because we're saying now they can show up with a payment in full the first week. And then what happens if we get...
Your ratio's off and you need another counselor.
Well, then you got to say, sorry, we have no room.
Yeah.
So I think you can do it, as long as it keeps you within a ratio. But if you've got one kid over the ratio, then you're going to have to turn that last kid away.
Yeah.
But you have to know that when that kid arrives with this check so that you're turning him away then and
so
not cashing the check and not taking the kid.
I don't think you really have that scenario.
Mm-hmm. Last year we talked about having them come if it was a later registration and being waitlisted. And then we could just call them back.
And say we can do it or we can't do it.
And they had to give their check when they were waitlisted, and it would be held until we verified they had a spot.
Why would we take their check if they're not going to tell them the spot?
Did we do that last year?
I wouldn't give you
the
check.
We told people, there was two people that we told we had to wait till the final week, and then that last week they were able to sign up because the ratio was just there.
I wouldn't expect them those to pull a check.
But they asked that way too.
You know,
they laughed.
That's my opinion. But
If they want to come, they'll supply a check when they're ready to be received.
Yep, that's what I'm thinking too. Because you're not turning anybody else away, you know.
Yeah, as long as you're keeping track of the wait list in order, you know.
And it's first come, first served on the wait list, I'm assuming. Okay, so we're good. We'll get some revised numbers from you as soon as we can.
Yes, you will.
And then after Friday, kind of like what the final number is. And if we have any extras, and that's a positive thing, but at least we'll know where we stand after Friday's numbers.
So are we waitlisting if need be, or are we just, or no?
I like you're so hopeful.
Yes, you're very hopeful, Celia.
You'll say yes.
Probably not needed.
All right, so that looks good then. At this point, both are going forward unless we have some unexpected numbers that wasn't where we thought they were. Okay, so let me know by Wednesday at the latest on team, and kind of an update of what you have today.
Sure.
And then after Friday.
So Friday closes, I can give you, and I leave for vacation Saturday, but before I leave Saturday, I can send out the new.
Okay.
How long are you going?
A week.
Okay.
Saturday.
Okay.
So, all right. What if we have this paper trail of registrations all year?
Yeah, Jody knows how to enter them.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and I know how to get them here. I'll get them to Jody.
Yeah. All right, so you check the box every day.
Not every day, every couple days I go in and check the box, and I've been checking the school when I go in to see that what's up there.
All right,
now I have to make copies.
Now we have.
I'm going to go.
Oh, that's right.
You know where I live?
Yeah, I do.
Call me, I'll stop by.
No, my thought process was going. Getting late. All right, any other questions?
No, I think I'm good.
So we're good.
Awesome.
Thank you so much.
Yay.
Yeah. All right. Brace yourself.